Hi, it's Cheryl from That's What She Said, and today I'm going to show you how to upload different files to xTool's Creative Space. So it is super easy, and I'm going to show you the differences between the files, and I hope that that helps you figure out which file you need and which file to use. So first we're going to come up here to this left-hand corner, and we're going to click the Image button. And that's going to open a folder on our computer, and you can just navigate to wherever on your computer you have your files saved. So I just have them in this folder, and I'm going to start with the SVG file and show you what that does. So I'm going to select the SVG, and then I'm going to click open in the Explorer window, and that is going to import the file onto the canvas in XCS. And it's honestly that easy. So let me show you really quick. I just want to show you what the design looks like. Let's see if this will give us a preview. Maybe not. Let me show you. Okay, so my design is a black be kind and a red heart. I'm going to delete that just for now because I just want to talk about the SVG file. So as you can see, if I select this, my be kind is inside a bounding box. That was the black layer. And then my red heart is inside its own bounding box, and that was the red layer. So it imports SVG files in the layers that you have it set to. So it's super convenient. I would say this is my favorite file to work with. If I select the file, it automatically imports as a score output, but I can come over here and I can change it to engrave, and I can also change it to cut. So I feel that it's just incredibly versatile. I can scale an SVG file as large or as small as I want, and I'm not losing any of, you know, it's not getting pixelated or distorted or anything like that. So SVG is probably my number one file to work with. Make a little tag here so that I can keep these straight for you. Okay, so there's my tag. This is the SVG. I'm going to put that back to score. Now I'm going to import a DXF file. So same thing, click the image button, and then from my folder, I'm going to choose the same file, but just saved as a DXF. And it always comes in large, so I'm just going to scale it down smaller. So here you can notice we have a lot more going on here. We have a lot more bounding boxes than we did with just the two layers here on the SVG. So not only is each letter its own bounding box, but then the centers, if they have a center of the letter, they are also their own individual bounding box. So there's just a lot going on here versus the SVG. So this also imports by default as score. And if I come over here and I click engrave, you can see that we have some issues, right? That's not really what we're looking for. And cut is perfect. So it works great for score and cut, but the engrave, you're going to have to do some manipulation on. So most of the time it's just selecting and coming up here. And I normally do subtract at overlap. Oh, so that didn't work. See, it's, you kind of got to, let's try just the B. It's really finicky. So like I'm showing you here, it's just not my favorite to work with. See, and then it just did it a score, but I can't make it engrave. Like it's only going to engrave the outline. So this is not my favorite. DXF is not my favorite, obviously, to use for engrave, but you can certainly use it for score or cut. So let me just put a little tag here. So we remember what these are. Okay, so that's those two. And now I'm going to show you what happens if you want to import a PNG or a JPEG. It's basically the same process for both, and I can show you. But here we are going to open up the PNG file. And this PNG, this specific PNG file does not have a transparent background. So you can see here that this white background is in our way. And if you see over here, my only option is to engrave this. So a PNG, I cannot score it and I cannot cut it. I can only engrave it. And I cannot engrave it as it is now because it's going to engrave all of this background area, and that is not what we want. So if you click on this edit image button, you can use this little wand and you can delete the background. Now, note that you need to delete the centers. See how we have the gray and white checkerboard here, but it's solid white here. There's still background here. So we have to select the background out of each of the centers of the letters. If you have, this is very simple because it's just letters and a heart, but if you were to use this for an actual photograph, you could use these sliders here in order to clean it up, to make it sharper and make your engraving more sharp, accurate. So for here though, for these simple words, I don't need to do anything with that. And so I can just click save. And now you see down here, it imports as colors. It doesn't import as lines, and I only have the option to engrave. So the exact same thing if I were to upload a JPEG, I'll show you just because I want to make sure we cover them all. Yes, scale it. Okay, so same thing, right? I have this entire thing with a background. I'm going to edit. I'm going to remove the backs and the centers. I'm going to click save. Same. Same as the PNG. I only have the option to engrave. So I hope that this helps a little bit. Like I said, my favorite file to use, I just find them to be really flawless and the most versatile, is to use an SVG design. But that is how you upload them. That is how you remove the backgrounds from photographs if you want to engrave. And I hope that helped.